Hello, my name is Grayton.
Ow, 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 my watch, my watch, my watch.
Beam me up, Scotty. Beam me up. Hi, my name is Grace, and welcome to my space. So today, we're gonna take a break from our skincare, makeup chatter, and chatter chatter, and we're gonna do some hair chatter. Mostly, I recently saw my sister do this hairstyle, and so I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna attempt to do it, and I figured why not film it. So, my sister did crochet using Marley. Not revolutionary, but I've done crochet, but I've never done crochet with like a net cap, and I've definitely never done it loose with like Marley like this to like imitate my own hair. So, hopping in with the stuff I have. So I'm using this. This is the Fritress Punta Cana Twist. I don't even know if this is like the right hair to do it with, but this whole three pack was $13, so I'm like, yeah. Then I bought two types of hair net, weaving nets. I brought this one that was like a crochet wig cap, and then I also bought, that's like an oval part, and then I also bought this like mesh weaving cap. I bought two because I was like, what if these holes are not big enough for what I need to do? What's funny is I used to do crochet all the time where I corner my hair. And like I've said before, anytime I do braids, I do my own hair and all that kind of stuff. So I've been doing my own hair for years. So I don't really know why this hairstyle has me so freaked out, but it's probably gonna be super simple and I'm overthinking it, which is what I tend to do. Okay, so last night, the big reveal. Anyways, so last night I like deep conditioned and then like twisted down my hair. So I did like four big twists here. And then I did these twists that we're gonna take out later. And then I did two twists in the back that we're gonna also take out later. So I guess the main event is having these like four like flat twists here that's gonna stay this way. And then I also oiled my scalp and like I used some like hair magic to do the twist. And I sealed it in, which I never do, but I use like beeswax, Australian beeswax to like seal the ends. Cause I know once these twists go under this weave cap, they're gonna be there for a hot minute. Before I even start, let me make sure this has got my crochet needle can go within the holes and come back out. That was like the thing that I wanted to be sure. Okay, yeah, this should work. So I'm just gonna pop it on the center and making sure to leave out those two that I made at the bottom. So I'm literally only doing like the center part of my hair. Yeah, so this is a closed top. I literally don't know if that's gonna make literally any difference. At this point, I know as much as you do. No, I don't know if this feels secure enough. So let me see about this other crochet weave cap and see if that one's gonna feel more secure, because if this is gonna feel more secure, I'm gonna switch over, hold on. Okay, I look crazy. That's fine, beauty is pain. Now this definitely does not feel more secure. Well, no, let's go with this one. Okay, so putting that back. Okay. Yeah, this definitely feels more secure. I don't know what I was thinking. Now I just have this other cap that I'm just gonna have. Okay. Sexy. So starting off, I'm definitely gonna cut this hair in half. So let me cut this hair in half. So I've cut the hair. They're like this. Now where do I go? All my sister said was like, you just put it on and then you crochet it. So, I guess that's what I'm gonna do. So first though, I'm going to stretch out the bottom and then let's go in. All right, it's fun. It's like you're watching in living color, me try to figure out if this hairstyle seems possible. Okay, so I have it in the loop. I have not done anything crochet on my hair in so long that I don't even think I remember how. Like, that's gonna sound crazy, but I don't even think I remember. It's been years since I crocheted anything.
And I think it's actually, yeah. Okay, yep, so I put the hair through the net and then I bring it through and I think I'm just gonna do a loop. Yeah, I'm just gonna loop it. One done. Now we gotta do that like a million more times. Pray for me. I'm listening to a podcast about the Iran-Contra affair. It's wild. Reagan definitely should have gotten impeached. Just saying. Well, I guess I'm done. This looks insane. So I'm going to take some of this moisture-rich leave-in from 𝒉𝒉 and I'm just gonna run it through the hair to try to relax it just a bit because it is really, really, really big. But overall, and let me just, okay. So now it's time to like trim and get everything super even. Okay, I'm going to make myself look cuter than I do right now, and then I'll be back to say my final thoughts on this quick hairstyle. I also want to make it clear, only an hour has passed since I started doing this hair. Okay, I'll be right back. So I'm back. Final verdict on this hairstyle. Wow, that was like, I have been doing my hair since what? Since I was 14 to like nearly 10 years of me doing my hair. And that was the easiest, most convenient, like, I can't believe it. Like, I'm literally just thinking about like how like the last, like the second to last set of braids I had literally took like 3 days. And that took maybe an hour. And in that hour, like I dilly-dallied, I sent messages, I texted, I hung out, like that, like this took nothing. It's crazy to think that this whole hairstyle took about the same length as it does to deep condition my hair. So I approve, I love it. I think my hair, I think for the 4C girlies, I think this is the perfect texture. This is the, like again, the Frietris Punta Conta twist. I didn't even use all of it. Like I still have so much hair left. So I might like run my hands through and try to figure out if there's gaps, which I really don't feel. But if I feel any gaps, I'll put more hair in there just because I literally still have some cut left. But this feels really good. It moves, it's light. It was smart to leave my hair out because leaving my hair out like covers it up. Please don't come for my edges. This is part of the reason why we're no longer doing braids. Ah! But like leaving my hair out has like really, yeah. Yeah, I support it. I feel like Chaka Khan. I feel like Chaka Khan right now. I literally love it. It is really soft. What's cool about crochet is like I have like easy access to my hair underneath. And so I think in terms of like how I'm gonna maintain my hair, I'll probably just like keep like, I have this stuff from, what are they called? Who is this brand? I can't find it, but I'll find it. Head and Shoulders has this like Royal Oil scalp care line that the nozzles are kind of like the nozzles for oil. And I don't know where mine is. So if I can't find it, I'll just get a new one. But it's like, you know, moisturizer is an elixir, but it's in that pointy nozzle to get to your scalp. So I think in terms of like hair care, my own hair care, outside of twisting and moisturizing the front and the back every night, I think I'm gonna be using that Head and Shoulders warrior oils to reach into my roots and get some conditioner in there, because it's not enough just to put oil in it if we're not sealing anything in, you know what I mean? But yeah, I love it. I think it blends really, really well. You know, y'all be the judge of it. It's cute. It's cute. It's cute. It's cute. I'm really glad I stole this hairstyle from my sister. It's like so affordable too. Like, what, that pack, I only used 2 of the 3. The whole thing cost $13.99. The wig cap I ended up using is this like Miss, honestly, Beauty Supply $1.99 wig cap. And then I had my crochet needles from all the times I used to do crochet. I'm thinking back to like when I used to do like corner my hair and then crochet it, like thinking how long it took to do those cornrows and all that stuff. And even then it was like a 4-hour process. And I was like, wow, look how quick this is. And now I'm like shook, cause I'm like, this is so quick, so convenient. It's fun, just a fun look. I support it. I love it. If anybody, like, try it out. I definitely would say you need to have the hair texture for it. So this hairstyle, at least with this hair, the 4s aside, I'm gonna need you to have some like kinky hair. Otherwise, I don't know if it will blend. But I'm sure somebody who has loose curls, let me know if this is something you would try and if there's hair that would blend in with your loose curls. But I'm excited to not have to deep condition my hair every day for like a couple weeks before I do something else. Or I might stick around with this. We'll see. We'll see, more importantly, how my edges like being out, because that was the big thing. I was like, I need a hairstyle that can let my edges be out while I regrow them, but I also need it so that I don't have to be twisting down my own hair and taking it out and like conditioning and doing all this stuff. Like, I want my hair protected, but I want my edges to be left alone. And I stumbled upon this and I love it. So, okay. Thank you again for coming to Grace's space. I hope you learned something. Maybe if you didn't, who cares? I hope you enjoyed yourself. Yeah, I will see you around next time for whatever chatter or thing I decide to record. Because at this point, I've just decided I'm gonna do whatever I want on this channel. But I'm thinking the next video is gonna be about K-dramas, because there is a K-drama that I recently watched that has me so messed up in the head, I must rant. Okay, bye everyone. Don't forget to like, subscribe, hit the notification button, hit the, is there any other buttons? Is that it? I think that's it. So do all the YouTubery things and come back and see me again. All right, adios, bye.